How's everyone doing today?
Good. Doing good.
They're doing good. What about you guys? Man.
Josh.
All right, here they come. Let's everybody stand. Thanks to everyone for being here. You may be seated. And, I hadn't planned on saying this, but I will say this. Chuck, you're in trouble. No, I've known.
Yes.
Yeah. I like that. That's get him back for the nose ring, right?
Yeah.
Welcome, everyone, and thanks for being here to witness a special occasion with Chuck and Mary as a united marriage. I'd like to start by just going to our Lord in prayer. Heavenly Father God, as we come before you today, we come in the name of your Son, Jesus. And Father, we just ask your blessings on this time and on this marriage. We pray that in everything that's done here, that you would be honored and glorified above everything else. In Jesus' name, amen.
Amen.
Well, marriage, as probably everyone's heard this before, and I know it, is as old as the family of man. It started right there in the Garden of Eden. Moses was a great lawgiver of Israel, and he gave the first legal sanction to marriage that our Lord Jesus Christ gave when he was on the earth, gave it the spiritual sanction. And something that we all need to understand is that it's not the state of Oregon that is going to seal your vows. It's not me as a minister that will seal your vows, but it is our Heavenly Father God who gives his approval and seals your vows. So rightly regarded, marriage is the highest of human relationships. And I mentioned to Chuck and Mary before, the second most important choice that you can make in your life is choosing your life mate, getting married. The first important choice is to accepting the Lord Jesus Christ as your personal Savior and trusting in Him. And so those are two very important choices, and both of those are held very high in God. Marriage is the preserver of true love. It's the foundation of the home, and it is the strength of our society. I've always believed that the if we have strong marriages, we'll have strong churches. If we have a strong church, we'll have a strong nation. And that's so important. So God's Word teaches us that marriage should be held in honor above all. So Chuck and Mary, if you have both duly considered this relationship upon which you're about to enter, I would ask you to indicate so by joining your right hands. Do you, Chuck Bruce, take Mary to be your lifelong best friend and wife? Do you pledge before God and these witnesses from this moment on to honor, encourage, and support her, no matter what your journey holds? When the way is difficult, and it will be at times, do you promise to stand by her and lift her up so that through your union, she can become more than she ever could alone? Do you promise to be one with her and her alone, body, soul, and spirit? And do you promise with every beat of your heart to always love her with everything that you are? Will you love her as Christ loved the church and gave himself fully for her?
Yes, I do.
And do you, Mary Wiley, take Chuck to be your lifelong friend and husband? Do you pledge before God and these witnesses from this moment on to honor, encourage, and support him no matter what your journey holds? And when the way is difficult, and again I remind you that at times it will be, that do you promise to stand by him and lift him up so that through your union he can become more than he ever could alone? Do you promise to be one with him and him alone, body, soul, and spirit? And do you promise with every beat of your heart to always love him with everything that you are?
I do.
So having come together in the presence of God, these witnesses, and having made your pledges to one another, I therefore, by the virtue of the authority entrusted in me as a minister of the gospel of our Lord Jesus Christ, and in accordance with the laws of God and the sovereign state of Oregon, I now, in the name of the Father and the Son and the Holy Spirit, pronounce you husband and wife, one in name, one in aim, and one we trust in a happy destiny. What God has joined together, let no man separate. Let's pray. Father God, again, we come before you, and as this couple has come before you also to exchange their vows, to commit their lives to one another, Father, I pray that as they do that, that the very center of their life will be you. And that they will not only honor one another, but they'll honor you even more so. So Lord, bless this time. Bless this union together as they go forth. Thank you for allowing us to do this in your name. We pray in Jesus' name. Amen. Chuck, you may kiss your bride. So, turn around and face everyone. I now take great joy in presenting to you Mr. and Mrs. Chuck Bruce.
With that, and then before we leave here, we'll all go outside. And I got a little rice we can throw at him, but we'll do it out this door here, okay?
Okay,
all righty.